Hello friends, welcome back to channel of Dr. Gaurav Verma. In this video, we will learn legendary symbols, paper number theory. First of all, what is the definition of legendary symbol? Let A belongs to Z, any number, and P is any odd prime, so that the GCD of A comma P is equal to 1. Then we define legendary symbol A upon P as A upon P is equal to 1 if A is a quadratic residue of P, and if it is minus 1, if A is a quadratic non-residue of P. It means Legendre symbol have only two values, 1 if A is a quadratic residue of P, or minus 1 if A is a non-quadratic residue of P. If P divides A, then it is simply 0. It gives 0 value. Now few examples there, 1 upon 5 is always 1 because 1 is a quadratic residue of 5. 2 upon 5, 2 is a non-quadratic residue of 5, so it is minus 1. We have already discussed about the quadratic residues and quadratic non-residues in the previous lecture. So we have known that these things, 3 is a quadratic residue of 13, so it will give answer 1. 5 is a non-quadratic residue, so it is a minus 1. So these are basic definition based things. What is the legendary symbol? This is the A upon P, which is given by two values only, 1 and minus 1. Now we have the first theorem. If A belongs to Z and P is an odd prime, so that GCD of A comma P is equal to 1, then we have to show that legendary symbol A upon P is congruent to A raised to power P minus 1 upon 2 modulo P. How can we prove it? Very simple way. We know that Euler's criteria in the quadratic residues, if A is a number quadratic residue of P, then we know that this result using Euler criteria, A raised to power P minus 1 by 2 is congruent to 1 modulo P. And if case 1, if we take case 1, if A is a quadratic residue of P, then we know that A upon P is equal to 1. So from both two equations, A upon P is congruent to, because from 1 we say that see that A raised to power P minus 1 by 2 is also congruent to 1, or A upon P is also congruent to 1. From both two equations we say that A upon P is congruent to A raised to power P minus 1 by 2 mod P. Similarly, if A is a non-quadratic residue, then we know that A upon P is equal to minus 1, and we also know that by Euler's criteria this will not equal to 1. This is not congruent to 1. But Fermat's theorem, we know that Fermat's theorem, this is a statement of Fermat's theorem. This implies the P will divide the difference of A minus B by using the definition of congruence. By making the factorization, P will divide this and to this, liking the formula A square minus B square A minus BA plus B. So either P will divide this thing or P will divide this thing. Okay, from here we can see that A raised to power P minus 1 by 2 congruent to 1 mod P, or either this one. This can't be possible as it is a non-quadratic residue. So only this one is left to us. So A upon P minus 1 by 2 is congruent to minus 1 modulo P, and we also know that A upon P is congruent to minus 1 modulo P. From both two equations we say that A raised to power P minus 1 to is congruent to A upon P modulo P. So we have this result. Now here from this result we also understand, if A raised to power P minus 1 by 2 is congruent to 1, then A upon P is a quadratic residue. If A raised to power P minus 1 upon 2 is minus 1, then A upon P is a non-quadratic residue of modulo P. Now we will learn some few properties regarding a Legendre symbol in this video. The first property is product of two Legendre symbol give again a Legendre symbol. Very easy one. If A and B are quadratic residue of P, then AB is also quadratic residue of P. It is a simple one as we studied in the last video. So A upon P will is a 1 because it is a quadratic residue. B upon P is a 1 because it is a quadratic residue. AB upon P is also 1, so it is a quadratic residue. So if we take product of these, it is a 1 into 1. 1 into 1 will simply means 1, and 1 is written as a AB upon P. So it is proved here. If A is the quadratic derivative of P and B is non-quadratic derivative of P, then we know that if one is a quadratic derivative, other is a non-quadratic derivative, then their product is also non-quadratic derivative. From it, we can say that A upon P is 1, B upon P is minus 1. So this is also minus 1. If we take product of these things, it will be minus 1. And minus 1 is equal to AB upon P. So in this case, we have already proved it. Similarly, we can prove for other cases. A is non-quadratic derivative and B is a quadratic derivative. So many cases. In all cases, we will prove this one. Okay. Now, second part. If A is congruent to B modulo P, then congruence is x square A modulo P and x square B modulo have a same solution or both have no same solution. Since A and B have both are congruent to each other, then we can say that since A and B are both congruent to each other, then we say that these two equations must have same type of solutions. Either they have solution, either they have no solution. Suppose these both have a solutions. These equations have both have solutions, then by definition we say that A and B are quadratic residues. So they both are congruent to each other. Okay. If they have non-quadratic residues, then they also have congruent to each other. Because if they are quadratic residue, if they are soluble, if they are soluble, then both are quadratic residues, so both values will be equal to 1. If both equations are not soluble, then both are non-quadratic residues, then both value will be equal to minus 1. Third one property, if GCD of A, P is equal to 1, then GCD of A square, B is also equal to 1. So, if integer A is a solution of X square, A square modulo P, then we say that A square upon P is equal to 1, because A square, if any equation of this type is a soluble, then we say that A square is a quadratic residue of P. This is the definition of soluble equation. If any equation of this type is soluble, then we say that this A square is a quadratic residue modulo of P. So A square upon P is equal to 1 by definition of quadratic residue. Now, second part, if A upon, and we know that it is a quadratic residue, then we know that if A is a quadratic residue of P, then we know that this is the theorem we have proved earlier. A upon P is a congruent to A raised to power P minus 1 upon 2 modulo P. If we take A is equal to minus 1 in the above equation, putting A is equal to minus, so we get here minus 1. This is a minus 1 raised to power P minus 1 by 2. As we know that it will give answer either minus 1 or 1. We have proved this equation here. On dividing with P, it will either give answer 1 or minus 1. So it is proved here. Further, if P is an odd prime, we can prove that minus 1 upon P is this one. We have already proved this thing in the above part. Here we have two cases. P is either congruent to 1 modulo 4, either P is congruent to 3 modulo 4. If P is a congruent to 1 modulo 4, then we can write P is equal to 1 plus 4k, and putting the value of P here, 1 plus 4k, after simplification, 1 plus 4k, 1 will be cancelled with the 1, we get 4k upon 2, it will give minus 1 raised to power 2k. Simply put the value of P here. Okay, so it will be a given answer 1 if P is of type this one. If we take P type of this one, then P's value is 4k plus 3. Put value of P here, so it will be given even number, it will be 4k minus 4k plus 2, after common taking common 2, it will give 2k plus 1, which is an odd number, so it is a minus 1. So in one case we get value 1, other case we get value minus 1. Simple one result. Now we have another theorem. If P is an odd prime, then summation of quadratic residue A upon P, the under symbol from A raised to power 1, A raised to is equal to 1, 2, like a summation P minus 1 is equal to 0. Let us say G is a permittive root, and we know that G raised to power 1 to 5 P is a reduced residue system modulo P. So since P is a prime number, so we can replace 5 P with the 5p will be p minus 1. It is a reduced residue system modulo p. since these are 1, 2, 3, p minus 1 number, then we say that 1, 2, 3, p minus 1 is a reduced residue system modulo p. If a is any integer among these numbers, then we can write a is equal to g raised to power k modulo p using the definition of indices for index theory. Any number can be written as a power of a primitive root g. So a is a congruent to g raised to power k modulo p, dividing both equations with respect to p. A upon p is a congruent to gk upon p. Okay, now we know that a upon is p is a congruent to a raised to power p minus 1 to modulo p. So a is congruent to this one, so we're taking the power p minus 1 upon 2 modulo p. It will give us, taking p minus 1 by 2 inside and taking k outside, we will get this thing. Okay, since g is a primitive root of p, and we know that this theorem g raised to power p minus 1 by 2 is congruent to minus 1, so we get this minus 1 raised to power k modulo p. So we will get the value of a upon p is equal to minus 1k. After putting the value in this summation part, minus 1k, when we open the summation, it will be give minus 1 plus 1 minus 1. So in this way, we will get a zero answer. Now, how to calculate these symbols? Now look at the first example. Evaluate Legendre symbol 5.13. Okay, we have three criteria to solve the Legendre symbol. First one is the method of Eulerian criteria. We have already discussed in this video, if a is 5, p is 13, we know that a upon p is a congruent to a raised to power p minus 1 by 2 modulo p. So taking a 5 here and p 13, on simplification we get 5 raised to power 6, and we have broken into 5 into 6 into 3 parts, like 5 square, 5 square, okay, and we know that 5 square is 25. Dividing each number with a 13, we get the remainder minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, because it is divisible by 13 divide 26, and dividing with the 13, it will give remainder minus 1. So on multiplication, we get minus 1 here. A upon p is equal to minus 1, though we say that a 5 is a non-quadratic residue. There is another way to calculate Legendre symbol, that is called Gauss lemma. In Gauss lemma, what to do? First of all, you have to find p minus 1 upon 2. It is a 6. Then you have to make integers taking 1a, 2a, 3a up to p minus 1, 2a. So since p is over here, since a is over 5 and this number is 6, we take up to 6 numbers, 5a, 25, 35, 45, 55, 65. So these are these numbers, and we will take modulo 13 of these numbers. After taking modulo 13, we get the remainders 5, 10, 2, 7, 12. What we have to do, we have to take the modulo 13 of these numbers. After taking the modulo 13, we get the remainders, and we have to collect those remainders which are greater than p by 2. We have to collect those numbers which are greater than p by 2. P is 13, 13 by 2, then it means 7.5. We have to take those remainders which are greater than 7.5. Okay, so 6.5. It is a 7, this is greater than 6.5. So these two numbers are also. So we have three numbers which are greater than p by 2. So it is a three numbers. So take n is equal to 3, and formula for Gauss lemma, a upon p is equal to minus 1 raised to power n. N is here 3, it is a minus 1. Similarly, we have other criteria. If a upon p is equal to minus 1 raised to power n, then n will be calculated by greatest integer function k a upon p, k raised to k is equal to 1 to summation p minus 1 by 2. So here a is your 5, p is your 13. Okay, the GCD is 1, then we have to find this thing. Okay, k is equal to 1 to power p minus 1. P is here 13, 13 minus 1 by 2, it is a 6. So we have to expand this summation up to 6. So putting the value of k is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now this is the greatest integer function. You know the definition of greatest integer function? If a number is at 2.5, what will be its value? Left integer 2. Similarly, you can find 5.13 is a 0 point something, it is a 0. It is also 0. It is a 1 point something, so its value will be 1. It is also 1 point something, its value is 1. It is also something 1 point, its value will be 1. It is a 2 point something, its value will be 2. So calculating these values, this is n is equal to 5. Okay. So a putting the value of n is equal to 5 here, minus 1 raised to power 5, it will give answer minus 1. So in this way, these are three ways to calculate Legendre symbol a upon b. One is a Euler criteria, another is a Gauss lemma, third one is based on the greatest integer function. Thank you very much for watching my video. Signing off, Dr. Gaurav Verma.